Human sacrifice. You know the time when we used to give humans up as prasad to our gods? You know, this used to happen throughout the world. Humans were sacrificed to various gods, whether it was in Rome, whether it was in, you know, South America. Literally all over the planet, there was a time when we were like, hey man, let's serve them up the best version of our sacrifice. One of us, to appease the gods, to tell them, hey man, we really care. So please give us a good harvest, take care of us, you know, all that kind of stuff. But then you say, you know, things have changed. We no longer do human sacrifices. We don't need to, you know, sacrifice humans to get what we want, because now we have science. But see, here's what I think. I see that if you think of science as a new religion, the new thing that's driving us forward, we still need a, you know, human sacrifice. You see, every time something is discovered, or when somebody's trying to make something new, they try something new, people die. And these people dying, weirdly enough, is important so that, you know, things get better. And that's the human sacrifice I'm talking about. For example, the guy who discovered sodium cyanide, the ridiculously toxic chemical, actually tasted it and still survived. But then he also tasted arsenic, lead, and lots of other heavy metals and died of, you know, heavy metal poisoning. Or Madame Curie, you know, who discovered radiation, but didn't know it was so dangerous and died of, well, you know, because of nuclear stuff, radiation. So you see, science does require sacrifice, and it's crazy how many people have to die to move the world forward. Of course, this is in the context of the greater good, but either way, human sacrifice is needed for science to progress in a very weird sort of way. We actually did a podcast on this. It's called Inventors versus Inventions. It's super fun, and if you like this, you might like that as well. You can check it out here. And if you like this and you enjoy this kind of content, please subscribe, because we have content up every week.